Okay, I want to do just a couple more examples from implicit differentiation so you can see how all of the stuff that we have done in chapter 2 kind of comes into play. So here's an example with the product rule. Find y prime. 3xy cubed is equal to 7x plus 2. Okay, and use implicit differentiation. So I want to say that the reason I have to use the product rule is I have this term right here that has an x and y both in it, and they're multiplying together. So I use the product rule there, here, for this left side. So f is maybe 3x, f prime is just 3. G in this term is 3y cubed, and g prime, I take the derivative 3y squared and then times y prime because this is implicitly defined. Okay? So then the product rule is this fg prime plus gf prime, right? So I get 3x times 3y squared times y prime plus y cubed times 3. And that's the left side of this, and then I'll go ahead and differentiate the right side. The derivative of 7x with respect to 7 is just, with respect to x is just 7, and the derivative of 2 is 0. Okay, so let's simplify this left side. I get 9xy squared y prime plus 3y cubed equals 7. And then I'm going to come down and go ahead. And again, I want to solve for y prime and get it by itself. So I move the 3y cubed over to the other side. Seven minus 3y cubed now on the right. And divide now by this term 9xy squared to get y prime by itself. Okay. So you do have to be aware of where these things might be coming into play, but otherwise taking the derivatives of these pieces is pretty much the same. Let's do an example of the quotient rule. Okay, so I want to find y prime for 3x plus 1 over y cubed minus 2 is equal to 10. And again, I have this defined. There's obviously a division sign or a fraction in here, right? And in both the numerator and denominator, I have these pieces that are dependent on x. I have x in the numerator and y, some function of x in the denominator. So I'll use this, the top here, is 3x plus 1, and the derivative of the top is 3. Bottom, y cubed minus 2, and the derivative of the bottom is equal to 3y squared, and then times y prime, right? So that same chain rule coming into play over and over again in this particular case. Okay? So now I use the product rule, bottom times the derivative of the top minus the top times the derivative of the bottom over the bottom squared. Okay? This is just all for the left side. I haven't done anything with that 10 yet. So I get y cubed minus 2 times 3 minus 3x plus 1 times 3y squared y prime over y cubed minus 2, and that's squared. Okay, and really that's the right side, and on the left I have to take the derivative of 10. The derivative of 10 should just be 0. Okay? Whew. Okay, now I really do want to try and solve for this y prime. Right there. Okay? So I'm going to try and go ahead and get that all by itself on the right side. When I do that, it is going to be maybe a little bit messy to try and do that, but let's go ahead. So I would say the first thing that maybe I would do is multiply both sides by this denominator here. Okay? When I multiply both sides by that, it gets the right side is 0, so I just get 0 on the right. And let me go ahead and multiply these out as well. So I get, for the numerator, 3y cubed minus 6 minus, and I'll leave this in parentheses to make sure the minus comes okay. So 9xy squared y prime plus 3y squared y prime. Just like that. And I will then distribute this minus and then figure out what I'm talking about in this particular case or where I'm going. So there's my y prime and there it is. So I'm going to move everything else over to the right side. So I get negative 9xy squared y prime minus 3y squared y prime is equal to, then I'll get negative 3y cubed plus 6. Now I go ahead and factor out this y prime. Okay, y prime times, and what's left over is 9xy squared minus 3y squared is equal to negative 3y cubed plus 6, and divide both sides by this term on the right. So I get negative 3y cubed plus 6 all over negative 9xy squared minus 3y squared. Okay? Gross but very doable algebra in terms of solving for y prime. Okay, and let's do one more involving the chain rule, and then we'll kind of be done, at least with the examples that I've planned. Y plus 3 to the 5th equals 4x plus 3. Find y prime. Okay, and again, here's this chain rule, so I use the general power rule here. This 5 comes out front to differentiate, the inside stays the same, and I decrease this power. And then this is the derivative of the inside. So I have this, y plus 3, the derivative of y with respect to y is just 1, and then I have to multiply by y prime. The derivative of 3 is 0, so really this derivative is just y prime. Then I differentiate 4x plus 3 and I get 4. Okay, and then solving for y here is pretty easy. I got it all by itself. I'll just divide by this piece here, 5y plus 3 to the 4th. So I get y prime is equal to 4 divided by 5y plus 3 to the 4th power. And there you go. Okay. Okay, so let me know if you have any questions.